Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Just mastering the lost tapes of The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Are we going? Is this it?
Buddy, we're going.
You saw me wink at you, didn't you?
I was too busy staring through the mirror.
You know what this is? This is the lost tapes. How can you tell? Because we get to stare into the sweet, sweet face of the...
Tattletale and the gang.
Extraordinarily well-lit fugues.
I mean, hyper-lit.
I mean, they are lit.
Like a diorama.
By the way, that you've made a point several times that you're like, wait... Are all the lights actually... Because he sits in the chair that you used to sit in.
Yeah, which I moved. And I'll say this. I think the chemistry's improved since I moved chairs.
I like it.
Does Lewitsky agree?
Totally.
The spine of the bonfire agrees? The backbone?
Fuck my yeah. Back's not to the crew now.
Yeah.
It works it
we
works
talk
good.
Right here. We got them and the guests to the other side. It's just fucking great. But you're right. I did sit in that chair at the head of the
and
table.
It is, as we can see, looking through that porthole right now, all lights...
Focused.
Pointed in one direction only.
And you know
Captain's
what?
Chair.
It really shows you what kind of people we are because we turn the lights away from us.
We're like, oh, I mean.
I don't want any light.
I think this room's too lit up.
No one cares what I have to see. Well, speaking
I'm over here in this dark corner.
Speaking of fucking us avoiding the light or whatever, I noticed something that's serious today walking into the lost tapes. And I don't know if we've ever touched on this, but I walked in and there was a famous guy. I don't know if he's from a band. I don't know if he's an actor. I don't know if he's an athlete. I've never seen him before, but he's clearly famous because he has people around him with that energy of like, what do you need? Do you need something? He's an important person and he's here to do an interview. I get off.
What do you look like?
Light skinned black dude, mid-size. I don't really know. Look, mid-40s.
His best friend is a black guy.
True. My best friend is a black guy.
Do we have the list of who was here today, Lou? We could probably piece this together.
Holy shit, I do.
Yeah, I'd love to look through it to see who it was.
I missed Dave Matthews yesterday. I'm so pissed.
Is this today?
I have the whole week, actually.
This is Tuesday.
Oh, yeah. Tuesday. I need... That's what today is.
Yeah,
so here we go. Let's see. No. These are performances.
No. Jerry Saley?
Nick Cannon and Wild 'N Out Crew was here. That bums me right out.
I don't know. I didn't get a quick look at him. All that happened was we were walking out, and his crew, I got off an elevator, and him and his crew got off their elevator, and I did like the whole, like, hey, you guys go first. Like the nice thing of like, hey, we're all walking in the lobby. You go through the doors. You guys go first. And he gave me a look of like, fucking.
The famous one.
Like the famous guy gave me a look like, fucking, no, it's not him. Like, fucking move. Like, move, motherfucker. Because I think he saw my badge, so he thinks I'm just like an employee at Sirius, and I'm like, it's so funny how you don't give a shit about a person. Like, I looked at him like, who the fuck are you to treat another human? Like, you're not important. I don't care who you are.
Right.
And that, I think, like, I think that's famous people's kryptonite. Like, I should have said something. Like, I don't care who you are. I'm just trying to be nice and let you walk through the door. It's just, I don't know if it was a 0-60 Soder thing. Or if it was just like, but the dude was like clearly, you know, famous people when they suck, because you've met a lot of famous people, and when famous people suck, they just assume that you're on their jock. And when you don't know who they are, they're powerless over you, so you're kind of like, you're a fucking asshole. And that's what I was like furious walking to the studio.
Was this hunk of shit right here?
Who is that guy?
Roderick something?
That might have been him. No.
Oh my God! Is he over there in Fugelsang's studio?
No, it's Jordan Carlos. Oh, okay. I rode up with him. He was the guy that I got off the elevator with, and we bumped into there. Yeah, fuck. That might have been him. I don't know.
Black Lou, you want to bust in there and see if
get your ice
if Jordan
on?
Carlos knows who that famous black guy was?
Yikes. Were they with Nick Cannon at all?
No, this yeah, might have been like a Wild 'N Out crew. 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, but Nick Cannon.
He was over. He was older. He was like mid to late 40s. But anyways, it really was one of those.
So
I do too, because the guy just gave me a look, and I was like, "Man, what the fuck,
motherfucker!"
But just like,
we're never gonna find this out.
We'll just move.
Oh, wait. Oh. Maybe this might be it.
Hey, watch out, Jacob.
You're no. Fucking faggot.
Whoa. Jacob,
come on, man.
That wasn't him.
We know our buddy Jacob is recouping still. Although this is a lost tape, so if not, we're so sorry to hear about the loss of Jacob Batat.
His shark tooth will be on sale on the Bonfire website.
Shark tooth. We will be having a fire sale for Jacob's apartment.
Jacob's angel. Hi. Okay, I'm up in heaven, guys. Don't worry. All the Titanic's here. Even Jack and Rose.
Do you think...
Lou, I'm always going to be here. Right in here. Guys, don't talk about Fugelsang. And then when you die, you will come join me in the kingdom of Titanic.
Oh, man, what if you die, Lou, and Jacob's there to grab your hand at the top of the staircase?
In the kingdom. In the kingdom.
No, that was not the guy.
That's a white guy.
A well-built.
Lou, will you come see me in the lobby of a very crowded cruise ship? Hey. Where every day involves clothes with... lots of buckles and lace and
how about
several layers?
26 buttons per item.
Do you want to wear a shoe that's so complicated to put on in eternity?
It's the worst. Why can't we have Velcro sneakers up here? It's heaven. This is the rest of time.
No, hopefully Jacob's healed and now he has a fucking robot back. Did you hear about Jacob?
Oh, wait, go back, Christine. It said Red Sun. Go back to the lineup of the day. Red Sun Rising. Are they around here? We know those guys.
We do know those guys.
They're on Octane.
They're on Octane earlier. They had a performance.
They're gone.
Can anybody find out if Red Sun Rising's floating around?
Yeah.
You know what I just noticed? You can see what people are here.
Like these guys.
Those were the tattoo guys I saw performing. That was earlier.
White
you should have said...
Yeah, they should be gone.
You should have said, oh, those were the tattoo guys I saw banging your mom.
Wait, what? Good band, dude.
Red Sun Rising?
Red Sun Rising, yeah. She can bring up some of their stuff if you want. Yeah, they're fucking like a funky metal.
Okay.
It's good.
That's metal them funk?
Right there. The guy, I know the guy... pretty well. We hung out on the boat a bunch. I've never seen a guy walk in a super, super smoking hot chick. Just with stares at him in a hallway. Really hot, Christine. Would you argue, right? The girl is a beautiful chick.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in the rock, like, you know, big fake-titted sense of the word.
Okay.
But she just goes,
nice shine away from the fight.
She stared at him and he's like, what's up? And she goes, what's up? He's like, where are you going? She's like, wherever you're going. He's like, come on. She started walking with him also, and I'm like, Jesus.
Really? Mm-hmm. That's like that scene in Kingpin where Bigger McCracken's eating with Roy, and he goes, hey, not you.
Yeah.
You.
Hey.
Hey. Hey.
She goes, not you. Hey.
He was also a white guy that was pulling off cornrows.
Is this him?
Not the lead singer.
Wait, the dude that pulled... player. Oh, the dude that pulled the big-titted hot chick? Him?
Yeah. I would have told you this guy. It's the guy with the long hair in the back.
I would kill for that. That kind of confidence. You're just like, hey, walk with me.
Let's see. Are they going to show him ever playing the guitar? Him is the guy. Awesome, though. Awesome band. So we can see if they're floating around still, Christine. That'd be great. So, yeah, you got fucking Big Dog. You got big leagued by a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Treat you like a bitch. Not treated famous like enough bitch. For anyone to know who he is.
Not famous enough for even me to recognize him, but you're kind of like, dude, who are you? Who's in your camp? Who's around you that's just pumping you up that much where you just think you could just walk through like, move. I'm here to entertain.
Yeah, he sounds like a real fuckstick. I'll tell you who I met last night on an SDR show. I think you would have liked her too. Black Lou would have been all about it. You know who it was?
Yeah, the porn star?
Yeah.
Who?
I met her before. She's awesome.
Nadi Ali.
She's amazing.
She is...
Bring her up!
She's not the brightest bulb, but I'll tell you this, man. Her body, she was wearing a one-piece green, like...
Yeah!
It doesn't... Her body is just, like, ridiculous. She's, like, 100% ass, no way, like, no waist.
And
natural little titties.
Like, did you have fun interviewing her, or was she, like, a fun hang on the show?
Man.
I just heard Christine breathe right through her nose loud.
No, she was good. Listen, she's a sweetheart, for sure. She was fine, but, like, she... didn't get almost anything I said joke-wise at all. And she's not a porn star anymore. She does eyebrow threading now, which
great.
Is hilarious.
Great.
In its own. And I don't think she really wanted to talk too much about it, but her body is bonkers.
Did she just want to talk about eyebrow threading?
No, I mean, briefly talk about porn, but that's the most interesting story. Also, SDR shows.
It's always
like
a weird
hour.
Thing. Where you
SDR shows an hour, and we got to get those like things in on them. But like, yeah, that's basically what she was kind of wearing yesterday, like that. Yeah, like that gray thing.
Yowzers.
And yeah.
If you experience me, you won't even know who your ex-boyfriend is.
Yeah, she's pretty hot. But I mean,
hey, Circus Seal.
She's a goofball. But you know, again, she's not a talker. She's a, you know, a girl who gets gangbanged by black guys and now does eyebrow threading.
I mean, the eyebrow threading thing is like, was she doing the thing? Because I always wondered about this about SDR when you bring up like their porn stuff, and they're like, well, I have a lot of other hobbies. And you're kind of like, why are you here?
She wasn't shitty, but she didn't really dig too much
sex. It's not called eyebrow threading, drugs, and rock and roll.
Listen, my frustration of the whole thing, I'm like, why did she come on and she's just going to do eyebrow threading? Like, her whole thing's porn. Like, is she going to eyebrow thread naked?
Yeah.
And, you know, obviously that's not necessary. Like, all right, don't, I guess.
Did you know going
in? I don't understand the point. Well, and then the thing was, Lainey, I guess, asked Christine about her doing Bonfire, and I'm like, I mean, to possibly do what?
Yeah, I mean, if she doesn't,
like, she's not getting undressed. I don't think she would talk about porn, but she has like a real. I think there's definitely more to dig in deep with her on is the fact that she got in a lot of trouble
for what?
She's like Muslim and not allowed back in Pakistan. And yeah. So I asked if she was willing to talk about that, but honestly, hearing her on the show, it's she's just like, not really like a. She doesn't seem like she speaks very eloquently about.
You're gonna have. I'm waiting for the fucking nice way for you to say she's a dumb dumb. I was trying to watch you grab for that. Christine goes, she's not. Words are just, not her friend.
Here, ask me about how my porn affected my past. I'm gonna get. You know, if you could deal with this, if you could handle this,
yeah, we can have her on the show.
We'll have her on. Okay.
So, you know, does your porn ever come back up in your regular life now?
No, it was like, you know, I'm Muslim, so like I can't go back there and stuff, and like, you know, some of the family did the whole disowning thing.
Well,
mom and dad are cool.
Who in your family disowned you?
Just, you know, extended, whatever, they did the disowning thing.
What's the disowning thing? They just won't talk to you again?
It's like, you know, like they disown you, like they get, you know, like they don't talk to you anymore. And you
I'm
know,
sorry, I can't
Muslim.
Take it anymore. Can you just okay, blow someone
yeah.
on camera? I'm sorry, this conversation is like you're...
It's just like Muslim thing.
Oh, man. When hot girls don't develop a personality, it gets real bleak in your 30s.
What a waste of a good load.
True that. Christine now just shoots eyebrows up on her phone.
Like. True that. But she was nice to look at. She was definitely nice to look at.
Should have played this. She would have gone fucking nuts.
Goddamn right.
Well, that's the thing. Like, Muslim girls' bodies are so insanely awesome.
Yeah.
But not
that's
a
what
lot
I
of
yell.
Muslim
that's what I yell at the
around.
Mosque as they walk in front of my apartment. I go.
Your guys bodies got the, are awesome.
They
your
body, really are. That's
even if you have the down
up.
Comforter over it.
Nice she, bodies.
She had a surgery though. She said she got like fat taken out of her stomach and put in her ass.
Yeah.
Oh.
Which does make for a great ass, it turns out, Dan.
Did you see her butt?
She was just wearing. I mean, she was wearing a skin tight one piece thing, like with like pants though. You know what
It'd
I mean?
It'd be
like,
funny if someone was getting their eyebrows threaded and they're like, "You need to do something with that body." And she's like, "Oh, I have."
I mean, dude, I wanted so bad. To,
those ass cheeks.
Yeah.
Right?
You're right, Jacob.
Right, Ghost of Jacob? Right, Angel Jacob?
I'm always with you.
I'm
yeah, there she
wolf
is.
Now.
Yeah. That's her doing.
And she, I feel bad because she was like very sweet.
She was very sweet.
She wasn't, you know, she just doesn't seem like much of a talker.
I don't want to make fun of her, and I think that's what we're going to fall into if we have her on here.
Yeah.
I mean, she was very
the reason
nice.
We don't have Fell Dog on.
She was very nice, but we're going to like, we're going to make fun of her. But man, she is nice.
Someone
to
tweeted at Fell Dog. And used me in a tweet, and then he retweeted it, and he was like, look at that, did you see Soder? And I'm like, dude, you gotta understand, if you tweeted us with Corey Feldman's tweets, Jay and I can't read them. Yeah. We're blocked.
We have no idea.
We're real motherfuckers.
We're real ass.
Oh.
What?
Lewis hears that and goes,
has anybody ever taken that?
Hey, hold on. Someone used it without trademark?
his ears are like,
he goes, James, put down the Legos. Someone's using real ass.
I gotta jam out.
Skateboard out. Pennyboard out. Yeah, that, what was his
name? Yeah, I don't know. You get lost in those fucking Muslim eyes.
I get it. She's got some fucking Jasmine eyes.
She is, very, very hot. But she, yeah, she didn't do anything weirdly naked. I don't know. It's an odd, I don't know. I'm not sure exactly what Lainey's representing her for. If not
PR, maybe to get people to go get their eyebrows.
She's
started?
Like she doesn't. That's the only PR. Lainey's the only PR person anybody in porn knows at all. So even they go, I left porn 6 years ago, but I'm going to open up an arcade bar. Lainey, can you get me some TV appearances or some radio spots?
Lainey, my new husband does drywall. How do we promote it?
And it's I go on a thing? I'm not going to get naked or do anything weird.
The very sexy Alyssa and her husband, Jake. And he's like, hey, you guys need me for drywall?
Well, we looked at those pictures
roofing
before.
Roofing.
I told you, Danny Daniels.
Crown molding.
Crown molding. Chair rails. Danny Daniels' husband and what was the other one? Oh, and that guy Sid we were showing you that was with... But I mean, she's unbelievable. Her husband is just a dude, just some guy.
Yeah, a guy that has to fucking just bite down a lot and be like, God damn it.
Yeah, but
he's just into it.
I'm saying, dude, she is also.
He's just into it.
I don't imagine if you marry a porn star that you're biting down.
Yeah, you're not like.
I imagine you're pretty like turned on by it.
Isn't that weird? Because I remember when porn stars used to go on Stern, like Tara Patrick or whatever.
Well, look.
And sometimes when Stern would talk to him, they'd do this thing where like, well, he just doesn't really care, but you're right. What they were dodging the whole time is like, nah, your husband's into it.
He's into it.
He's into it.
That's what
it is. Because you can't marry a girl that's just getting fucked and not being like, hell yeah. Because immediately you'd be like, please just shut it down.
Well, Lucas Rossi, you know, he explained to me with it, you know, his, now it didn't happen while they were together at all, but she was Kendra Jade, the porn star, and he,
she's smoking hot.
Yeah, and he says, I just saw her. They just came out to see me in Nashville. They're the sweetest.
That picture of that guy just fucking has hands down on that girl's neck, and you're like, that's my wife!
But he said it's a turn on to see her, like, you know, like that he can just go turn on a video and see her getting fucked. And I get it. I fully get that. But Danny Daniels.
Moves. I mean, she might be sweet. They are wonky.
Yeah. whatchamacallit? Danny Daniels is just, and Christine saw her too, is just alluring. almost no makeup, just a girl you're like, wow, you just always look fucking perfect. I bet
she's a girl you'd see in like that with that magazine Perfect 10.
Yeah, I loved Perfect
like,
10.
She really
what
is just like a naturally beautiful chick.
Do
there's
they do,
no surgery, she doesn't look porn star, she's just you see and you're like,
man,
what a gorgeous girl.
Can you see if
Isn't
there's
that big
Perfect
Beaver?
10?
Oh,
Jay goes, and then the hair, get down to the fucking carpeting.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
That thing is shag.
Gaga ga, goo. Yeah, Perfect 10 was like real hot smoking chicks.
It was,
right?
it was run by an old creep.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Can you see the guy that
ran
right
there? The guy with the bald head or whatever.
Oh, that's great. And he's like, ladies, do you want an opportunity?
Oh, God.
Just look up the owner. Look up his name.
That's him?
Yeah. Norm Zeta.
Norm Zeta.
You guys are in here just to hang out?
You guys want to be in a magazine? Or?
The guy is great.
What?
That's exactly the guy who opens up Perfect 10 magazine. Well, I like to choose women by their beauty and their natural breasts.
Joan Rivers and her new boyfriend, Norm Zeta.
What?
Joan Rivers dated Norm Zeta?
Fake news.
That might be real.
Keep checking. That's your home.
That might be real.
I mean, good for... It kind of makes me like him more.
Well, you know, she likes people that are perfect, though.
I'm a perfect... Except I didn't have half the surgeries that the girls in the magazine did.
Everybody's perfect, though.
Wow. No, that looks like...
Yeah, it's legit. So what?
I mean, it looks like it's all the same picture.
Let him be happy. But,
I love that he ran Perfect 10 magazine, dated Joan Rivers. That makes me like him more.
That's what I just said. It's like, oh, he's got... he's just with these girls where you're like, huh?
It's the same thing about with watching, like, Hef all those years. I mean, in all the years I've been alive, and I mean that, by the way, that I've known who Hugh Hefner was, it's always looked weird.
Yeah.
Now, look, young Hugh Hefner... In the tuxedo
Definitely.
All the time.
Oh, wearing the robe. When he wore the robe when it was sexy and charming.
But the slick hair and everything like that.
Yeah.
You know, that famous picture of him smoking the pipe. You're like, sure, man.
I get it.
You got a harem of chicks. Now, look, a lot of them are still for the money, but they're not grossed out by fucking.
No.
I mean, by the end, these girls got to, like, move tubes and a fucking bag full of your shit getting pumped out of your stomach to suck your old gross dick. And he still has the confidence of, like, they love it.
He goes, I'm a romantic man. They like being with me.
Ladies, do me a favor. Can you push my asshole meat back into my asshole?
Hold on.
Oh, you love it.
I will fall asleep halfway through.
Don't you think it's more like he just doesn't give a fuck if they love it or not? He's fucking hot, girls.
Yeah.
Girls, I haven't had coffee in 20 years. Why does my breath always smell like coffee?
Weird.
You love it.
You weird. Oh, yeah.
You love it.
You absolutely. Don't you, Holly? She's like, I guess.
Look how you can... My body's so mushy and old, you can jump on my stomach and nothing else moves. It's like a Tempur-Pedic.
Don't I feel like...
And you love it.
Don't I feel like a freshly wrung out sponge? I'm soft and squishy.
Every part of me feels boneless, and you love it.
While soft or screwed up, I got my wiener out.
My wiener out.
That's the weirdest thing to me, is that... And Glazer has the same thing. It's just, at the end of it all, everything is punctuated with, and you love it.
I mean, guys that have that, you're certain breeds of dudes.
I'm envious of
just
that.
Have that where they're like, then we did, dogs are there, chicks love it.
Bing, bang, boom, dogs there. Yeah, dude, it's really, I'm intrigued by that level of confidence. I'm going to watch that, when we should do that, both of us should watch that show, Age Gap Love. It was recommended to us on Twitter.
Can you bring up a trailer?
It was brought to us on Twitter, but it's a series on Netflix called Age Gap Love, and it's about...
Christine, can you look up Age Gap Love? I want to see this trailer. And it's about what? Like old men dating young women?
I believe so.
There it is.
And milk? Here we go.
Something to keep yourself nice.
To sugar daddies.
Huh? You love me, yes.
To cradle snatchers.
I like young men.
Hey. It's time to get a little transgenerational.
She's pretty hot.
I am going to die one day, but I want to be prepared for it.
The series that proves love knows no bounds.
Nice.
Take a picture of Kelly cutting the grass.
Age Gap Love starts Friday 8:30 on ABC 2.
It's
on Netflix.
Oh, is it? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I found her down at the school stop. There's no pedophilia laws.
But I don't know. Like I said before, I've said it before on the show, I just don't have the constitution that could... I have a rough time still with a girl that's like, I find to be like beautiful, that's like, it seems to be like, is this girl fucking whipping it at me? So I'm like, that's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I don't
know.
What
are you doing?
I don't ever feel comfortable with that.
Just because you're like, you're always like, you know, like...
I immediately
there's
go like
not gonna be. It's like, you know, every guy you fuck, if you wanted to, can be like fucking jacked,
yeah,
rippled, fucking.
Well, I always am like,
amazing
what are you,
dude
what are you
with tan skin.
Yeah,
I'm always a white, like, pasty freak.
What do you want from me? What are you trying to steal?
What's
from
your
me?
Angle?
What's your
it's
angle?
You. They're trying. They want to steal you a little bit. That's been described to me before, and they're right.
What does that mean?
It's the way you can deal with it in some way. And these old men is not the thing. That ends up being a lot of money, because.
But what does that mean? You could steal.
I'll tell you. Okay. These guys. These old men go that what they lack is, generally speaking, yeah, there's things no one's that freaked out by it when you see, like, if you're like Keith Richards is fucking a 30 something year old, you
yeah
know what I mean, you're like, yeah he's cool. Mm-hmm. I get, like, you could find what's cool about him.
Mm-hmm.
You just watch him get off stage, even though they're all gross looking when they get off stage, just like, whatever, that guy just fucking rocked the Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, like, that's something. This isn't cool. So I've had to get into my head. I'm like, what they want from me exactly isn't, they're not coming in for a chiseled body and whatever, they want me.
Yeah,
that's what they want from you.
They want voices.
By the way, I'm not saying
they
want
to be fucked by
they women. Have to be attracted to you physically to some degree.
They want
to
be fucked by a guy that does voices.
I mean, essentially, but
you that, want to get your pussy ate by Winnie the Pooh.
Nom 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 nom.
Oh, there's honey in there.
Nom nom nom.
Oh,
nom,
look
nom
inside these lips and you'll see a bunch of honey.
But it is that
nom 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 nom.
You know, not to take that from that one of my favorite comedy fight stories ever, but they want, like, your essence around them a little bit.
Yeah.
They want to feed, and that's not a bad thing. That's fine. I don't think that's a problem with that. I'm just saying, but that's what it is, because they're not. Because, by the way, it's the same reason if a girl, there's plenty of really good-looking, in-shape comics
yeah
that aren't very funny, and they get laid, they'll go bomb at places and get I saw that happen all through open mic years, you know what
oh
I mean?
Yeah,
and just fucking pull pussy in the night, goes, because the girl, that girl's has nothing to do with him being funny
at all. He's got on stage, he's good looking, that's it for them.
Yeah, that was the fact that he got on stage was the bonus to go, it's like, well, I'm definitely fucking this guy, he's doing yeah something too.
Yeah, if he would have been the bartender at the comedy club, he still would have gotten fucked.
Right, exactly. Yeah,
it just helped that he went up and bombed.
It just made it look like
he could take a punch.
And those guys, by the way, never go, oh man, this is I'm eating shit. They go like, you fucking pussies don't get it.
Yeah,
you fucking dorks don't know they what's going on here.
I mean, look at Holly. Good God, she was my favorite out of those. She was, Holly was the hottest.
Of, girls, oh, Hefner's Girls?
Yeah. She, just like the way she dressed and everything, I was like, good for, I mean, she just seemed down with it.
How many times she's wrapped those hands around a liver spotted dick?
Oh, my God.
I couldn't believe he married somebody that wasn't her after that.
I loved Holly. Bring her up. How's she doing? Yeah. Who's she dating? She's like married and she has kids now.
It's Holly Madison, I believe, right?
Yeah. Good for her. Yeah, man, she was easily the hottest.
She does have like that dipshit face.
Oh, though. I love it.
You like that?
I don't know where the remote is.
You were just watching TV, Holly.
Wait, that's, so DVR is like a tape?
So I didn't put a tape in. I tried to put a tape in the DVR machine and I broke it.
But
She's a mom.
She's a mom now?
Full mom. She went full mom, and then now they do the thing where it's like
box is blown out.
Oh yeah, but now she's got a lot of clothes on, and now it's like a lifestyle brand, right? Am I right? She running her own lifestyle brand?
Yeah, forget that you saw my clam a bunch.
She has a million followers.
Yeah, well, it's probably a bunch of dudes that used to
1,000,001 now. Dan Soder just clicked.
Follow.
Holly Madison just got a blue check in her followers.
She put out a book from a New York Times best-selling author. Well.
Sure.
I don't know, man. Let's just quit. You want to just go home?
Yeah. You want to go home?
You guys want to call it a day?
You guys, this has been fun. Let's
Holly
just go
Madison,
home.
New York Times number one best-selling author. Guys, you want to just call it a day? You don't want to drink today, Lou? You sure?
I kind of want to drink
sure,
today.
Lou?
Can I drink today?
Today you want to hold off because you got to work with your Italian friends later, so you don't want to be drunk. But you're going to try to get the rest of this day sober now. You're going to do 6 hours of radio. That makes sense. That makes sense.
Number
good
one.
Good call, Lou.
Number one.
Now driving. You're thinking what you're
you
sober
seem
head.
Like you're getting driven to drink.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, buddy.
Number one New York
oh,
Times.
Oh, buddy.
Isn't that crazy?
Not famous fake tits and sniz. Number one New York Times best-selling author. Son of a bitch. New shit. I'll tell you, man. But then everything goes with that, I was going to say. Maybe it would be better just to be the abs guy and not quite as funny. But then you're like, well, I'd rather be funny.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. You'd rather be good at your job.
I would.
And be
you'd rather
be underappreciated than overstretched and overvalued.
Oh, yeah. Do you know how many episodes of Cops I watch where you just see a good-looking, like, really, like, even, like, shredded dude just with a piece of garbage wife and 18 kids and just... There's always dirt on his face. And you're like, well, that doesn't always pull you out of the gutter.
Dude, I remember one time.
At some point, you're going to need a functioning talent or, you know, ability,
there's
skill.
There's a dude working for Delta at the Boise airport where I was like, what are you doing? What are you doing with your life? You're fucking gorgeous. What are you doing here? He's just like,
nothing. I'm going to go take a smoke break.
He goes, I fell in love with the love of my life in high school. And you're like, all right, good. I'm glad you're off the grid. I'm glad I don't got to compete with you. You Adonis.
Has that ever gone the opposite direction where you've seen a girl that maybe you're not into, but she does something that makes you want to be into her? Is it really like
funny.
Not?
Yeah, gymnastics.
Just
yeah. that ping pong trick with her pussy.
Yeah, yoga. Shopping for yoga pants.
There's
all those things.
There's been
really
girls where I've been like, oh, she's pretty cute. And then she's like, funny. We were talking about one of those girls before the show where I was like, oh, yeah, she's cute. And then like I hung out with her and I was like, man, I like her.
I know we went to work on it on Monday, but genuinely,
a girl that can
sing, like really actually pretty voice, like play piano, sing type thing.
That gets you?
It would make up for some looks for sure.
Me, it's sense of humor, man. If you're funny, holy shit! Like,
well, the good news is, if a girl fucks you, you immediately think she's funny. So
perfect. No, I didn't say she's funny, Jay. I said
I like a girl's a good storyteller
and is super
funny.
I go, Jay. First off, pussy doesn't whip me like that. I don't think you're funny. I think you're a great storyteller.
Oh no, buddy. The one you gave us outside was
really.
You said in the same conversation, she has she tells the best stories. He goes,
man.
She's really really funny.
Oh like, man!
And that's when I went, Dan, shut up.
Oh man,
I'm sure she's great.
Whip.
He said he texted me like yesterday. Can a girl live?
Oh no, I didn't. It was Sunday. Texted a girl on Sunday and she didn't text me back. She's friends with Christine and I was like, tell her what the fuck, it's Tuesday.
I know,
and I thought I had the wrong number.
So bad,
you know who it is.
Oh yeah, nothing.
She didn't text me back at all. I just checked my phone. She didn't text me back.
I think she's...
This bitch playing games, Christine!
She may have gone so hippy-dip that she's off the grid on phones.
She's texting Christine right now!
Oh, yeah. She's not off the grid.
Christine is reading the text on air that I'm like...
Oh, but she may have changed her number so she doesn't have your
that's
number.
That's what anymore. I thought, and then yeah, I checked the number. No, it's her number.
Okay.
We checked.
Okay.
No, I'm 1,000% on the losing end of this one.
You're fine. It's a shame, too, because that girl we're talking about particularly, really funny and fucking fantastic stories.
Great story.
Can I tell you something, Black Lou? This girl can weave a tale.
I hate you.
Like,
some call her
no
John,
one's business.
I call her the John Steinbeck of Queens.
She tells the stories. I pepper them with voices. I mean, I'll be honest with you, Jay, I hate to be this guy, but I think I have to get my girlfriend on the show now, too.
Dude. Kelsey. Kelsey's a good hang.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
It's all right.
Edit.
No, you don't have to edit it. We're not even fucking... She's not texting me back. There's nothing to talk
about.
Doesn't
matter.
I'm so glad we're not live right now. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, no, it's all right. This will come out in 2 Thursdays, and then by that time, I'll really be shamed because I'll be like, she never texts me at all.
Yeah, not even a who dis.
Who dis? Not even a new phone.
Well, yeah, lost all my numbers. Who dis?
Sorry, it's not saved. How are you?
Oh, yeah, good. How you been? I've been busy.
I've been very busy.
I'm busy now, but now I'm not busy.
Do we have to take a break? We should take a break. I don't have Jacob in here with his frantic energy. Jacob, if you're haunting the studio, move a can around.
I hover like Airwolf now. I'm on the astral plane.
Jacob's still out. And
Is he out still at this point?
Well, I mean, he's not here.
It could be weeks and weeks.
Months.
Well, I'm saying when this airs.
Maybe years.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. This is going out next. You're right.
We did live.
You're right.
We did the live at Moon Tower.
Jacob died weeks ago. Everyone.
No one has even checked on the body. And I'll tell you this: it's gotten hot in the last 2 weeks.
Yeah. You think you're going to give him? You think you're going to give him pain medication?
He goes, I have to tell you before I go under. Huge opiate fan. Turn it to 11.
They go, what? The dials only go to 10.
I know.
I don't know what kind of fucking anesthesia you got, but I'm going to need a double dose, bitch.
He goes, load it up.
Yeah.
He goes, kick it. DJ, kick it.
Patatsky on the ones.
All right. Here we go. Look, Deb, what are you doing down here? What are you doing down here?
I was swimming through a tunnel and I saw a light. And there was a hook with a worm.
Hey.
And I bit it. And it dragged me out of the water into a seascape.
And then I learned there he was, Airwolf. Not the guy, but the helicopter.
Unmanned.
Playing the cello. By the lake. It all makes sense. I was Airwolf the whole time.
Airwolf.
There'll be no more Airwolves. But you may feel a little sick.
We're going to take our first break. We'll be right back. It's the Lost Tapes on the Bonfire. Hovering. Planking. Living.
Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Black's got the muscle, Mexicans got the knives. You better be wise, you want to stay
iced
alive.
Tea. Remember? Before he was a chubby detective working for SVU?
Just collecting all that fucking... That SVU money.
God bless him. He's so rich, Ice-T.
Yeah, a lot of money.
It's the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95.
Yeah.
It's the Lost Tapes. We're back.
We are back.
Full disclosure, we are just back from a break. The third segment's always going to be the loose cannon for y'all listening at home.
This is the first two are precise. Together.
Well, in the pocket.
Well, they're all the same day. The first two segments are the same day. The third one's...
It's fucking all over.
Terminator timelines.
Yes.
This is a video we've been trying to get to.
Long time.
I want to say months.
Easily. I watched this in a hotel room. I forget whereabouts the country. I don't know if somebody sent it to me. Maybe Justin Silver may have put me onto this. But this guy does a series of videos called Prison Talk. It's great. He just sits there.
I just realized that Ice-T sampled the Halloween theme.
Mm-hmm.
That's how dumb I am. I just sat here for like 2 minutes and I was like, oh, that was the Halloween theme.
It's one of three things I could play on piano.
You could play the Halloween theme?
No, just... Dun, 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 dun.
That's...
It's three.
Oh, man, that's the best.
Boom, boom, boom.
Andrew Andrew Schultz putting on Instagram that he might that he's in the new Halloween. It's a Danny awesome. McBride one. He's got a cameo.
It's pretty
fucking awesome.
I'm so
that's
jealous.
That's one of those things where I was jealous. I was like, fuck, that's great.
I'm jealous of that. I'm very jealous of Tom Papa being in a they're doing a I guess a threequel. What do you call that? A trilogy?
Yeah.
Of the House of a Thousand House of a Thousand Corpses. I'm catching this guy's shit.
Yeah.
House of a Thousand Corpses trilogy. They're doing a Devil's Rejects like follow up.
And he's in
called
it.
Called Three from Hell. Yeah. And Tom's got a small part in it. I'm like, that's all you want to do is a small part.
Yeah, you just want a small part. You just go work on it for a couple days. Pete Davidson's in the new Motley Crue movie.
You know, yeah, I'm jealous of that.
So is David Costable, who plays Wags on Billions. And so, David Costable, he's such a big, like, he's such a good actor that it's like comics. Like, you don't bring up what you're doing.
He's the cheek slash guy that was in, which one is he?
He's the number two to Bobby Axelrod. He's the one with the mustache.
Yeah. He was Chibs in Sons of Anarchy. He's got that. You don't see that scar on his face? Have you ever talked to the guy? Yeah,
he doesn't have a scar. I know for a fact he doesn't have a scar on his face.
Doesn't he?
No, you're thinking of a different guy. He wasn't on Sons of Anarchy. He was Gil on Breaking Bad, and he was worked at the newspaper on The Wire. He was in Lincoln. I mean, the dude.
That's so funny. I'm thinking of the same guy, but it's.
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, different actor.
That's a different guy.
That's you're right. Yeah, all right. Fair enough.
But you know what's so funny? When you just said that, I was like, am I that fucking dumb that I talked to this guy and didn't notice a giant score on his face?
No. You were right. I was wrong.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Score one for the Sodes.
Sorry.
The name I'm pulling up is Big Herc.
Yes.
Big Herc.
Big Herc.
Is the guy that we're going to get to.
Yes.
Oh, but you were saying the Motley Crue thing where I said Pete Davidson's in the Motley Crue thing.
Well, it's the jealousy stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Tom Papa thing. I'm like, man, I really want to be... I got very upset in Devil's Rejects, the film Devil's Rejects.
Yeah.
There's one of the other, especially that time when it came out, one of the other white guys that was doing the black comedy circuit just has like a small part in it. And then it was in another one of Rob Zombie's movies in a small part. Like Rob Zombie just... I toured with this cocksucker doing comedy right before him every night, and he still has no fucking idea who I am.
It's amazing because it's funny about that when you get jealous of comics outside of comedy. Like
that comic's name is Redbone, by the way, and it's a great dude. Very, very, very great dude.
I love Gerard Carmichael, and he's going to be in the new Tarantino Manson movie. And like, oh, fuck. And he was in Transformers. You know, he got to go run around with robot cars.
Robot cars?
Are you telling me to draw Carmichael gets the robot on?
Oh, he was in the new one, the newest. Yeah. Was he really?
Yeah, he was like a scientist.
That really came and went, that movie, huh?
Oh, yeah. The Transformer franchise is fucking donezo.
They're getting a nice rough Rotten Tomatoes listening?
I think so.
Man, I'll tell you what. It's my fear of ever having a major part in a movie is that Rotten Tomatoes, man. Because I was looking to see what they did about Amy, and like she's getting, I mean, good reviews too, but I mean, the bad are just so mean.
Yeah, I mean, like, that's the thing. Shit. I think when you get up to like Amy's level, you just don't really read a lot of criticisms. I think you just
see if the network gives you another movie again.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I think you're just basically just like, what's up? Can I make another one?
Movie
like,
studio?
I mean, Jay, you know, Jay and Kevin from Broken Lizard, when they're in here, we were asking them that, and you're like, oh, well, you guys, are you comfortable with the fact you know you're just getting another movie? And they're like, we never know if we're getting another movie.
He also did say, he goes, I mean, we'll probably get another movie.
Yeah. That, like, when you hit seven and more than two of them are successful or even cult followers.
But they're all cult. They're cult.
That's
they're
fine. Cult for sure. That's what you'd rather have, because then in a case, you're almost like Brian Regan. You're like selling out on the road. Everyone knows about you, but mainstream still isn't like, yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah, well,
Brian Regan is is a legendary comedian. Would I call him mainstream? Maybe.
Sort of. I don't understand, but he has his following. Look, I tell you, that was Fenoy's thing. He's always said to me, he goes, there's something cool about being, not that I want to be them particularly, but like, you know, Fish, like, you know, all these big bands come together to do like the Bonnaroos and whatever, but Fish can go, we're doing a festival of us.
Dude, I've
for
always
3 days, and they do a festival of just Fish.
Yeah,
they play three shows a day.
This is called Scooby Dooby Walk down by the River. You can go validate your parking right now because this is gonna be about a 98-minute song.
Yeah, that's what they did the first Bonnaroo, I think. Then they were like, yeah, we don't need like,
we'll just do it ourselves.
Like, we just do it ourselves. And they just do 3 days themselves and have the same amount of people as fucking Bonnaroo.
And you know what? You know, I'm always blowing them on this show, but I've always said if I could have the career of a Queens of the Stone Age, yeah, like, if
fair, perfect,
then fucking great. You have diehard dedicated fans.
He's wealthy.
He's doing well, but here's the thing, he gets to make what he wants to make. If Josh Homme wants to go make them Crooked Vultures with Dave Grohl and John Paul Jones, you can do it. If he wants to go do drum on the Eagles of Death Metal.
Because it wasn't going to be on Power 100 FM anyway.
You're not going to be like, hey, we're back. Taylor Swift has Queens of the Stone Age opening. You'd be like, what the fuck? But yeah, that's why Dave Grohl's kind of got the best version of that. Dave Grohl has, I was in a legendary band, I made my own Hall of Fame band, mm-hmm, and I've done a bunch of other awesome shit. Do you remember that death metal album he did, Probot?
Mm-hmm.
Lemmy. Yeah, can we play that song, Shake Your Blood?
There was actually a video for it, wasn't there?
Yeah, with Lemmy. You can't buy this album on iTunes, I don't think.
Really?
Yeah, this was it. Yeah. R.I.P. Lemmy.
Here we are doing what we do again, Dan.
Watching videos?
No, not that. That's fine. There's audio. It's just we said 15 minutes ago, we've been trying to get this video for months, I believe. Haven't gotten to it yet.
You can buy it!
Jacob,
you can
buy it on iTunes! Over in his grave.
Come on, guys!
Can you hear? He's going to have to go down to the subway and have that guy teach him how to move a piece of paper in here or something.
He goes, get off my train! He goes, I would rather be on a boat!
If Jacob does die, we have to put him out to sea in one of those things we found.
Oh, hell yeah.
You know, the little shark that you get inside?
He goes, let me swim with my school. Let me go back. Let me go back to the way it was.
DJ, what was that?
When I was a shark! When were we doing that?
The foxhole crew.
Dude, when we did that Marvel Punisher thing where we were filming us cooking and we were doing Lemmy into the boom mic and no one was laughing.
No one got it.
And it was one of the funniest
things. Why does the chef want to follow us both?
Oh, he just doesn't like us.
He seemed to not enjoy us at all.
They had the boom mic down and we were doing a lemon cooking show. We're going,
if you want to fry it, I'll tell you what to do.
You take the chives, you put it in, mix it around.
And they were not laughing. They were just fucking.
I don't care if you're no carbs like a lady boy. Turn it up to 350 to bake and set it right.
And then they're just
it's
like,
it's a miso glaze.
Yeah.
Panko dusted.
They were just fucking looking at us like we were assholes.
Farm to market is how I cook.
I like pork. It is the best. A good old seasoning is the rest.
The other white meat.
Man, sometimes people just don't appreciate our bullshit, but you guys do because you're the campers. And of course, you can address a letter to the Bonfire in care of Jacob Batat, B-A-T-T-A-T. Send that to the 36th floor, 1221 Avenue of Americas, floor 36, New York, New York. Avenue of the Americas. You get what though. You could also just say fucking 6th Avenue if you want to, bro. New York, New York, 120. 10020 is the zip code.
You'll get some stickers. You'll get some limited edition badges from our live events.
Send a self-dressed stamped envelope, and we'll send you some fucking shit around the office because we're just trying to clear it out.
And and I believe starting.
Yeah, I didn't know that dropping existed.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you are the best, Lou.
I mean, Lou is.
We watched that again.
Good morning, Julia.
We watched that again in Austin together.
Yeah.
I forgot after. He goes, can I have a hug? And he goes, sure, I'll give you a hug. He goes,
can I have a hug, please?
Can I have a hug?
Dude, can you get just that noise? Play it again.
Can I have a hug, please?
Can I have a hug?
Can I have a blowjob, please?
Can you please get out of my town logic? Yeah.
Can I please have some Talenti? All right, let's get to fucking the thing we were going to finally talk about.
Big Herc. Prison Talk. This was the one that was showed to me initially. It's the only one I've watched, and I was intrigued.
You only watched this one. You didn't watch the whole series.
Oh, I have a feeling we could do a lot of lost tapes on Big Herc.
Really?
Big Herc seems like a guy that you're like, I should hire this guy to do something in my life. Like, he should be security but I feel like even talking to him, like, trustworthy security. And, like, someone who's, like, seems like an all right guy. But, man, he describes in such cold, just, like, whatever details, being in prison and the things that happen. And this one, I found out the term they use in some prisons, I suppose, for fucking other inmates in the butt.
Yeah.
It's called cheek busting, which is a hilarious word when you're a giant, scary, muscular black guy with a wicked lisp.
Oh, let's see it.
Cheek busting. This is cheek busting.
Prison talk.
Hierarchy. Is there a cheek busting hierarchy?
It's prison talk.
Prison talk.
With Big Herc.
What's up, everybody? This is Big Herc with Prison Talk.
I mean, he looks like Ving Rhames with a lisp. He goes, are you okay? Go, I'm pretty fucking far from okay. Now, here's the thing. Your L.A. privileges are revoked. When you're gone, you stay gone.
Stay gone.
Ving Rhames is... I don't know if he could be Marcellus Wallace with that lisp.
Oh, no. There's no fucking way. Although, it would
be... You feel that burning in you, Butch? That's pride fucking with you. I'm sorry. I can't take the lisp.
Pride fucking with you.
That's with pride
you. With you.
All right. Sorry.
Big Herc is so black, by the way. His lips, his inside lips, and everything about his lips is the same exact color as his arms and head.
He's a giant dude.
He is black everywhere you could be black.
I want to say thank you to tuning in to another episode. If you haven't got a chance to go on our website, please do so. We have a lot of cool stuff.
Let's get the plugs out of the way. I'm going to be performing at the Wacky Tech in Lower St. Louis.
Get your cheek busting soap on a rope. We sell it at prisontalk.com. You also have a toothbrush that turns into a shank. A lot of stuff for all your friends that's locked up in the inside.
I will deviate for a second and say I got so bummed out. This happens a lot with the cartoons. You don't watch all the cartoons, but if you do, you're going to get bummed out because almost every cartoon I watch, some point in the episode, I go, oh, so-and-so, myself included, has a joke like that. Fuck.
What cartoon?
I have a joke like that. Like the McFarlane stuff, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Or whatever, Bob's Burgers. But there's always just something where you're like, ah, man, I have something like that I've said. And it's fine, but it really is. They got me the other day. Roger, the alien, was saying he was about being in Nam.
Yeah.
He was like, it was the worst time of my life. He's like, I had to hear Fortunate Son every day of my life in Vietnam. They just show how it's playing that. And he goes, wow, that sounds like a nightmare. Fortunate Son every day. He goes, well, sometimes they'd also play that There's Something Happening Here song. And that just made me laugh too. There's something happening here.
Yeah, a little Buffalo Springfield.
What it is ain't exactly
every
true.
Every day. That is like, I think of this, Buffalo Springfield, Fortunate Son, and also Green River.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I think it's been in a couple of Vietnam movies. Come on down to Green River.
Oh, no. Listen, John Fogerty wrote music for Vietnam.
If you liked a war scored by John Fogerty, you're going to love...
John Fogerty.
That's what I call Vietnam.
Well, gonna mow down some gooks now, and they're hiding in the rice paddy hall.
John, the label kind of wants you to step away from the Vietnam stuff. He goes,
okay, all right, I'm sorry. Well,
the album's called Napalm.
I have some alternates.
Yeah.
Looking for some nips in the patties, I'm gonna blow them into yellow chunks.
Honks. Dude, one of the funniest lines from the John Mulaney SNL was when they were doing the walkout, the gun walkout, and the kid had the boner, so he couldn't walk out.
Yeah.
And then the pro-gun kid talks about going hunting, and he says he shot him with an assault rifle and turned him into red dust. Red dust made me laugh. He goes, I shot the gopher, and then he was red dust. That's so fucking perfect.
Red dust. All
right, let's get back to Big Herc. Prison Talk.
T-shirts, we have hats. We're going to be having shoes pretty soon. Some slides. Check us out
lisp.
At
We have shoes.
If you're watching this for the first time, please stop laughing.
Control yourself. Have some very pertinent information. I'm going to tell y'all.
You know, some people are born with lateral lisps. I have what some people call a palate lisp. What is that lisp called?
Why is hair lip?
Is that the hair lip lisp?
I think so, yeah.
Because this is the lateral lisp.
Yeah, this is the hair lip lisp.
I don't know what fifth one is.
I tell you, what's really uncomfortable is why is Black loosening with a notepad and a pen underneath Big Herc? Is he going to take this information in just in case?
I think he's writing rhymes. Lateral lisp sounds wet or slushy because air flows around the tongue.
Dentalized lisp is what we're talking about.
Dentalized lisp occurs when the tongue pushes against the front teeth.
Oh, no. It's the interdental lisp is this one. That's
when the tongue protrudes between the front teeth and S's or Z's is pronounced...
Yeah.
That's different. Oh, God.
Oh, there's so many more.
At the Bonfire SXM, we'll tweet out the four different types of list. What lisp are you? It's a fun new Bonfire quiz.
What's your stupid voice?
Yeah, you have dumb mouth. What's it? Which one is it? Hey, tard mouth. Which one do you talk with?
Hey, dip chops.
What? Hey, lazy tongue. Ah, dude. Yeah. Lisp is like a thing. Thank God. Dude, this kid, when I was in seventh grade, he had lateral lisp, and he stayed with his mom's boyfriend for the summer, and me and my friend Byron could not let it stop. I mean, we just talked to him like this. He's like, guys, stop. And we're like, we'll stop when you stop.
Everybody stops later.
Yeah, he goes, I mean, we're all in this together. We're summer friends.
Oh, sorry, Black Lou. Back to school.
Back to school. Big hurt.
If you got any questions, make sure you hit us up at freshoutseries@gmail.com and also subscribe to our Twitter and Instagram, which is freshoutseries. I had a question from one of our viewers. Hey, Big Herc, I'm a longtime viewer and love the Fresh Out series. In one of your videos, you said that people who associate with punks are looked down upon. But in prison shows, the big dogs or shot callers usually have bitches whose cheeks they are busting. Is it so that the prisoners at the top of the prison hierarchy are the ones busting cheeks, and prisoners at the bottom of the hierarchy are the ones getting their cheek busted? Best regards, a fan from Finland.
Finland.
I would like to know about your cheek busting. Would you say that there is a hierarchy to your cheek busting?
That's pretty interesting.
Ooh. Ooh.
That sounds like a Finnish guy taking it in the getting his cheek busted.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Is that the sensation you're talking about?
Ooh, it's like my boot is biting into a York peppermint patty.
Ooh. He's really fucking my boot good.
Fucking my boot good. You fuck my boot good.
My chooks have been boosted.
Oh, chooks boosted. Hello, Big Hawk. I was wondering if you could come to Finland and chook my boosts. Boost my chooks.
Boost my chooks.
Boost chooks.
Now, to be honest with you, man, I never seen a big homie bust another motherfucker, a little homie's cheeks out. You know what I mean? Just on GP. I know motherfuckers who did time in the feds who have been down 20 years and all they do is beat their meat. You know what I mean? Look at fuck books and make fifis and shit like that.
What's a fifi? Pause it. We're getting a hole into this. Is that the fake pussy?
Yeah.
That's with the rubber glove and a little bit of fucking. Yeah. You take a little bit.
He goes, the last ingredient, Dan, always love.
Yeah. He goes, make a good fifi. You got to put your heart into it.
Yeah.
Prison fifis.
Is that one made of carpet and mud?
Is that a fucking scratch post from a cat?
I don't know what the hell that is. It doesn't look like it's something that's good.
Yeah, it looks like... Oh, it's prison talk again! He just brought up... He's bringing up the fifis. I like when you Google fifis, Big Hurt comes up.
He makes up half these words. I've never heard cheek busting as a thing before.
He's your one-stop shop for prison info.
But here's the thing. I bet when we dig into Big Herc, there's somebody in the world who goes, man, this motherfucker ain't done shit. He only went to jail for a month or something. That's not even a real kind of facility. I bet someone challenges this shit.
We have some motherfuckers who are savages, you know what I mean? Who don't give a fuck. They're doing, you know, life, and they basically program themselves to be on man butt. You know what I mean? They like cornholio. You know what I mean?
They like cornholio.
Dude, this guy is.
His references are from before he went in.
He goes, TP from my bone. TP from my bone hole.
Yeah, you know, man, the first incarnation of Arrested Development.
You know, sometimes I bust cheeks and I go, where's the beef?
I'm talking about the first season of Will and Grace.
I stick my dick in the butt and I go, what the? What the?
Sometimes motherfuckers, you know, fall and they can't get up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Where's the beef? Yeah. You know, they have all that kind of stuff.
You know what I'm saying? Did I do that?
Sometimes you get your teeth busted. Sometimes you bust some cheeks. Kick ass.
Yeah, I ain't afraid of you.
I'm afraid of y'all, motherfucker.
I bust your cheeks.
type butts, and that's what they do. They prey upon young dudes who maybe have some feminine tendencies, motherfuckers who are sagging, showing off that ass crack, because you know you're sagging in there and you're showing your butt, you're saying that you're open for a motherfucking for cheek busting, and motherfucker will prey on that. But
he calls it cheapos. Like, it sounds like it's a child's rodeo event, like mutton busting.
Yeah, yeah.
We ride around on a lamb.
Yeah, with a fucking lacrosse helmet on.
Cheek busting.
Cheek busting fun. The Western Stock Show come through and they put some dicks and butts and we all have fun.
You see the girls working the lassos.
Yeah. Oh, the cotton candy's a must.
They got peanuts salty like a motherfucker.
I mean, it is. It's a fun time. Go check out some cheek busting.
Check out cheek busting down the old
Western Stock Show.
Give yourself a butt knife. Maybe a butt knife.
Oh, I'll tell you, they got good belts.
Thick stock. Thick. Real thick stock of leather.
Good. Even get yourself a buffalo robe.
I don't know of any OG, you know, running a who has the keys to the yard, who's running around busting cheeks. When motherfuckers find out about that, usually you get exposed. You know, I was at a spot, and there was a motherfucker named Big Mike. Big motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Shot I mean, caller.
If this guy is saying someone's a big motherfucker, that guy must have just been immense.
Yeah, he's a house.
Like a like Thanos. I mean, like really, like bigger than everyone else.
Yeah, there you go.
Bigger than everyone. If you're bigger than this guy, you're bigger than... This guy looks like... And you'll see at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter and Instagram, Facebook, you can see... I mean, Big Herc looks like... I mean, like Michael Clark Duncan. I mean,
yeah,
he's Michael Clark Duncan. He's a fucking house.
Yeah. He does look like Michael Clark Duncan.
Maybe he's short, but he's fucking huge.
Yeah, that guy's wide.
And he ain't fat.
And, you know, he was beastly. You know, he was known to put in work and shit. And everybody, you know, he was the man for a particular clique. I don't want to blast this clique out, so I'm just going to say Big Mike, he was the man for this clique. Anyways, a punk showed up. A Native American punk, you know, not to try to, you know.
My name is Busts with Coyotes. There have been many injustices to my people, but what you will never take is the busting of my cheeks. For my cheeks will stay perfect, like the sunrise out of the great Powder River. I understand. I bunk with man cunts, sleeps on bottom. I am Shanks with toothbrush.
I am Sharpened Spork.
I am Don't Touch My Fruit Cup.
That's your Indian name?
No, my name's Ross. I just didn't want to tell you guys what...
Cornbread's mine, you big moulin yawn.
I am Not Afraid of Blacks.
That's your Indian name?
Well, not really.
It's Fears No Ethnics.
Fears no ethnics. Walks with trust. Sleeps with back to door.
My Indian name is Dare You To.
Yeah, try it.
That's your Indian name?
My Indian name is See What Happens.
Yeah, my Indian name is Fight Me. I am...
Fight Me Dream Catcher.
Fight Me Lisp Boy.
That sounds like it was named for a particular...
That's
how fight.
You talk about me, particularly now that Native American man.
So hold on, punk. Your tribe, your chief named you specifically to fight me? That sounds like you trying to get your cheeks busted.
Sounds like your group's trying to get your cheeks busted.
Sounds like you are cruising for a cheek bruising.
Sounds like you just got kicked off the reservation, and they sent you over here to get your butthole blown open.
Yeah, let's get back to Big Mike.
A punk showed up. A Native American punk, you know, not to try to, you know, talk bad about Native Americans, but this punk was Native American.
Watch
but
it.
Very feminine.
For I call and you house as dark as night.
Ah, these right. He goes, you're on shaky ground, Herc.
Yeah, bigger.
You think he goes, not to talk bad about Native Americans. Your next words must be true.
I must tell you this. You must walk quietly and softly, for you are about to say the wrong thing. And for I have always wanted to bust the cheeks of a great dark warrior. For a great dark brave. Well, tell me.
And that is the story of when I split a mandingo in two. Cell block D.
He showed up. Big Mike was excited. Went to the warden and said, hey, you know, this is my partner. We did time at another spot. Could you move him in a cell with me? And the warden's like, oh, looked at the records. Oh, yeah, sure. You know, warden... You don't have a problem with motherfuckers getting their cheeks busted. You know, they on some old political shit, and they really, they don't let motherfuckers have fuck books in there anyway, so they don't give a fuck. They're on some weird old shit. So Mike moved the punk in, and this punk would iron Big Mike's clothing, cook his food, clean the cell, had the
cell
all
whacked. Just the whole vernacular he uses... makes me laugh so hard. Like, you don't have to call them fuck books.
Yeah.
It just, he keeps everything super prison while he's sitting in a lovely backyard.
Yeah, in a veranda.
I mean, he really, everything he said, he goes, they only have the fuck books in there. You could fuck your thing in the stank pussy.
Oh, there's a cold Arnold Palmer coming my way. Hold on one second. I'm outside of the Beverly Hills patio.
The perfect combination of lemonade and iced tea. Mm,
the man could hit an approach shot and mix iced tea and lemonade. I'm at the country club talking butt cheeks. Hold on one second, Reginald. I'll be right with you. I'm just got to finish up my videos. Oh, anyway, my videos. Back to being raped.
Oh, it's doubles tennis day. I didn't realize. Let me rust my cheek busting documentary.
I would love to come and play croquet with you and the missus. One second. Let me just finish up talking about this Native American black boofooing I got going on.
Sorry. In-laws. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You get it. Work never stops.
Went to work, came home, he had a bitch in the house, and that's how it went down. And the other homie who had a cell next to Big Mike's said he used to hear cheek busting at night. Big Mike was putting in work, you know, busting them cheeks out. And this dude, man, he was you would have never known, man, before the punk showed up. And then he tried to, you know, still call shots, and his homeboys weren't having it. They were like, nah, man, you're not repping us, man. We're not going to have, you know, a cheekbuster calling shots for our clique. It just doesn't look good for image. And Mike, you got to take a back seat.
I just want
to
let anyone know right here, this is a cheekbusting environment. If you bust cheeks, you can still call shots.
You can call shots and bust cheeks.
It's you know fine. What, guys? I know Big Hurt runs a different program. I just want to let you know Big Sodes runs his own program. And that is, we're cool cheek bustings here.
Flap it open, flip it down.
As Big Sode says, rip it, tip it, lick it, and stick it.
Stuff it with toilet paper, tell it to shut up.
Call me a turkey on Thanksgiving and stuff this bitch.
A lot of people don't know cheeks have a lot of tryptophan in them.
Yeah,
make you sleepy after you bust enough cheeks.
Bust a cheek, want to take a nap.
We don't realize is when you shoot out sperm, before the sperm's shot, there's actually a suction in.
Yeah.
It's how people get diseases. And sometimes you bring in the tryptophan off this neck, particularly the Native American punk.
So, and they call that the backdraft.
Sleepy. Yeah. I get a little sleepy.
All right, let's let Big Herc talk a little bit more before we take our break.
Mike, you know, was reluctant initially, but I think they convinced him that it's best that he just keep busting those cheeks out and do his time and let them handle business on the yard.
Dude, that's so great that there was a conversation where he goes, hey, man, Big Mike, I'm not going to stay in your way of love. I got to call shots now.
There you go. Here's the thing. I'm going to fuck this guy's butt and I'm going to call the shots.
I just don't think it's really a good look because I think you're distracted by your relationship. I know he's just moved in. I know how hard it is to live with somebody. I know you guys are having sex all the time. You guys are on the honeymoon
stage. Hey, Big Mike, are your friends here going to be? Are your friends going to be here all night?
Hey,
I'd like to get some sleep at some point. He goes, shut up, fucking Native American bitch.
He goes,
never stops. Well, you know, that's the price of love.
He goes, man, you know what? You're just dealing with new love. That's what that is. He goes, man, that mother, my squaw, never stops. He goes, hey, is it? Sometimes I feel like you don't have fun, as much fun with me around as you do with your friends. They're just having fun.
Hey, dare you to? Are you okay? He goes, it's just that I feel like Big Mike is always out and hanging out with his friends. I feel like the honeymoon phase sure is over here, huh?
Hey, what's up, dare you two? What are you doing out in the yard by yourself?
Well, it just gets lonely in the cell when Mike's hanging out with his crew, calling shots. So I decided to walk around. I never really noticed. I need my own life again. I used to talk to lots of people. Now, I feel like I just sit home waiting for Big Mike. I love when he takes to me like the way a snake cuts through grass. However, sometimes I kind of just wish he would ask me how my day is. I mean, the cheek busting's still on par. I mean, don't get me wrong, our attractiveness is still very good. The passion's there in the bedroom, but I not don't, in the living room. I feel the way when a fish has swam too far downriver. I do not know my surroundings. It's just that he watched the new episode of Iron Fist without me, and we promised we would always watch it together. He used to kiss me on my neck and called me his Pocahontas. Here.
It ain't respected, you know, it ain't respected. And even, you know, within cliques, some homies know about dudes busting cheeks and they don't really say nothing, you know what I mean? Like, they're not really giving his, what he says any weight. He's not calling shots, you know? It's like, other cliques look to you, whoever you're.
How do you say can't hang?
Oh, stewardess, I speak jive.
Just let him roll. We're gonna look more into Big Herc.
I mean, yeah, this guy's got a whole series.
I mean, and we're gonna have a lot of fun
that
with
lisp?
That. Oh, absolutely. Oh. So let's take our break and we'll come back with more Big Herc.
Oh.
Right here.
I'll be busting cheeks. I'll be busting cheeks the way I'll be busting quarter pounds.
Baby.
I'll be taking them. Oh, all of them. I'll be eating them. Bust the cheeks.
Give me them cheeks, buttery ass cheeks.
I'll be bad tired.
Let me get the buttery ass cheeks.
I got a sinus infection like a motherfucker.
We'll be right back, everybody.
Jason Williams is way cooler than this guy. That's Everlast on the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J Oakerson. No, I'm not behind this song at all.
You don't mean that.
I fully mean that. 100% mean that.
Nothing about you means that.
Oh, my God. No. I was upset that both the Lose started nodding their head to this. No, this sounds like a bad Madden remix.
This is not a good... Lou told me he has a very good version of this, and he was wrong. This is terrible. It sounds like carnival music.
Thank you, yeah.
No.
You guys ain't woke.
It's hilarious.
Jason D. Williams?
She found a Jason Williams who sang Folsom Prison Blues. Williams' White Chocolate, the basketball player, is cooler than Everlast.
But I also meant this.
No, you didn't.
This guy.
No, you didn't.
Get it,
that's
White Chocolate.
That existed.
This guy's just...
There's a guy named Jason Williams. He put the D in there, though, like Louis J. Gomez.
Yeah,
differentiate himself.
He goes, I'm Jason D. Williams. I don't dish.
There's already SAG. Someone already got a SAG. My name is SAG.
Is that why Louis did that?
No.
Oh, God.
He did it because Louis J. Gomez is the Dave Smith of Hispanic names.
Yeah, it really is.
Louis Gomez.
It's always funny when you find out who changed their names because of SAG. Like, who has different names.
Or who lies
who has the
about
same,
it.
Can you find that? Like actors who had to change their names who had the same name as other actors? Like if there's a Vin Diesel and you're like, ah,
I think Justin,
I'm a Vincent Diesel.
I think Justin says that he did it for SAG, but I think he just did it to play less Jewy.
Less Jew?
Yeah.
A lot of people pull back on the Heeb with the name.
I think that's what happened.
Guys, I should tell you this right now. My name's Dan Soderwitz.
Well, the funnier one is all the people... who are Greek to change their names?
Yeah,
just took Opolis off of their name.
Really?
I'm pretty sure like George Michael is George Michaelopoulos.
George, what about?
I'm pretty sure
Jesse. I mean, what's his name? The guy that played Jesse Spano.
John Stamos.
John Stamos.
Stamosopoulos.
Stamosopoulos.
I don't know about that.
Stamosopoulos.
His last name's probably actually Pappas. Pappas. Wasn't that his name in the show?
I didn't realize that Yanni's name was Giannis.
That makes sense.
Yeah, but I was friends with Giannis for so long that I was like, wait, I can call you Yanni?
You never thought to call me Yanni. I know, you feel like the year's been wasted. I know the feeling. You're like, fuck, I could have had that in the pocket always.
What a fun nickname, just to call him Yanni.
Dick.
Now I do it.
I think Jennifer Aniston is Jennifer Anistonopoulos.
She's Greek?
I believe so, yeah.
Is she really? She does have a Greek name. I'm trying
to
find...
Anistonopoulos.
I can't be Jennifer.
I'm telling you.
Anistonopoulos.
I'm trying to find SAG.
Fat Jew is in the studio next to us.
Who?
Fat Jew. I just didn't want to point and go Fat Jew, and you think I was pointing at you, Jay.
Like actual Fat Jew?
Yeah, the Fat Jewish.
Where?
He's the guy with the dick haircut.
Over here?
He's the one with the hair dick.
Did he lose a bunch of weight?
I don't know. Look over there to the left.
You can't see him. He's exactly where you are.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Let me go take a peek at the Fat Jewish.
All right. I'll play some music.
Fat Jew pick a movie. Perfect.
Nothing. I can't see
it. You can't even see it. Get up and look at him. What if he thinks...
A Jew brought prejudice against a fight.
Yeah. That's that handy.
Wait, the guy in the chains?
I don't know.
The guy with the huge dick on his head.
No, you have to come over.
We should just have him come in here and have him take some of our jokes for a profit. Miley Cyrus is not.
Well,
Miley Cyrus. Cyrusopoulos?
She was born no, Destiny.
Do that. Her name was Destiny?
She was born Destiny Hope Cyrus.
Katy Perry, go down, because this is when she was still like. Smiling.
Yeah, but her friends, but her family called her Smiley or something.
Yeah. Parents nicknamed her Smiley, which
I've dug deep.
Katy Perry's.
You got to put in the research. You got to put in the research.
Really, it's time. Time plus effort equals success.
No, you're just looking at people who've changed their names. Look at Greek.
I'm amazed.
Greek celebrities.
I didn't know Jennifer Aniston was Greek.
Yeah, Anistonopoulos. I'm standing by that.
I think so. It sounds good. Yeah. Jennifer Anastanopoulos.
I'm pretty sure George Michael Michaelopoulos.
Michaelopoulos. So you'd be Jason Oakersonopoulos. And I'd be Dan Soderopoulos. I'll do Soderopoulos. Soderopoulos sounds like a city in the future that only people in my family runs.
Only beautiful people can go there.
Only sprawling tall people with deep voice in Soderopoulos.
Soderopoulos.
Waiter to Soderopoulos. Lewitsky's Witskiopoulos?
Nah.
No?
Have you looked at
you just
look
mad
celebrities?
You're just mad at it like that.
Still ringing in my head. I'm like, how did I miss that? How did I think it was so great and you guys just did not even feel a moment of it?
You drink a lot, Lou.
By the way, there it is.
I know, but it gets me through my sober times in which I am now. not for long.
It's Anastas.
Wow.
Anastasicus.
Anastasicus. So many A's and A's and S's.
Anastasicus.
Jennifer Lynn Anastasicus.
Her godfather is Telly Savalas. There's a fun fact.
What? Really? I love Telly Savalas.
What was his line? Something, something, baby.
Telly Savalas?
Who loves you, baby?
Who loves you, baby? I'm Telly Savalas. Who loves you, baby?
Who loves you, Anastasicus?
Oh, look. Oh, Nancy and John Anastasicus.
This list is just famous Greeks without Greek last name. It looks like only some of them actually changed it, and it has those in parentheses.
Find me George Michael.
George Michael. I mean, Jennifer
right
Aniston.
Right there, George Michael. Oh, they're not going to give it to you.
Boo.
That's bullshit. Look up George Michael's real name.
Boo.
Zach Galifianakisopoulos.
Is Galifianakis Greek?
Galifianakis? Yeah, of course.
Oh, it's a super Greek name.
All right, guys. Well,
I don't
know a lot about Greek culture.
His name was, what the hell is his name?
Have a good time with that one.
Wow, Paniyatintulu. Is he Samoan?
Paniyatu?
You sure he's not Pacific Islander?
A Greek Cypriot restaurateur. Of course. They are always restaurateurs.
Paniyatintulu.
Metzger's old joke.
I just thought of that right when you said that.
Jesus Christ.
Diner monkeys from Assfuck Island?
Diner monkey from Assfuck Island. When he was talking about, it was Carla's friend.
Really?
They were Greek and it was all like they really wanted to keep everything Greek.
Yeah.
And Kurtz made a joke about like, wanting to date her, but he could like it made it up just based on her family. He was like, he wanted to date her, but her family was racist against me. Racist against me. Some diner monkey from Ass Fuck Island is going to be racist against me.
I'm blood prejudice against a thing.
Yeah,
that's fucking hilarious.
That's off his Comedy Central Presents.
Well, I think we're all are we out of the wake now of that horrific rendition of Folsom City Blues?
Yeah, who's in there? Who's that chick? Is that
that's Paris Hilton?
Son of a bitch.
Get her in here.
Dude, I love that Lou just said that.
Lou, get her.
Lou just said that like an old cop where he goes, son of a bitch.
Go get her.
Good luck. She's got a whole fucking fleet.
Go. We could ask somebody out front or something. Pictures, you creep.
If this guy gave
fucking
him...
Fucking voyeur Lou.
Yeah. Oh, she had great big boobs.
Great big boobs.
She's not going to...
Hey, why don't you guys stop gathering around like the Beatles just walked in?
Yeah.
And someone see if talent will send her in here.
That's what we're doing.
No,
guys,
now
you guys are...
You're sitting with your mouth open with your forehead against the window.
You guys are both flicking your beans to Paris Hilton being in his sparkly tux.
Why does every other show get these people at these times, Lou?
Well, that's fat Jewish in Paris Hilton. That has nothing to do with us.
Is that a thing?
Well, that's just like she probably came in to see him.
Why?
I don't know. Knowing our luck, he's probably got a show on Sirius.
Can we steal Paris Hilton for a second?
He goes, give me a pretty white woman. I want to take her next door.
Work your fucking voodoo magic, Lou. Now is the time.
Yeah, Lou.
Yeah. I mean.
Come on, Black Lou. Show him your amazing skills of saying hi to someone who you don't know.
Show him your black levitation.
Tell her you can levitate, but you have to get a boner first.
Oh, my God. They're doing a radio show together. They're doing a radio. I mean, we are. Flat out disrespected. Is that just Skrillex? Is that Mexican Skrillex?
Yeah, Skrillexes.
Skrillexes? Les Skrillexes?
Skrillexico.
Los Skrillexo? Los Skrillexo?
Los Skrillexico.
Yum, 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 yum. ¿Qué pasa?
Yeah, Black Lou.
Yeah.
He's going to get her.
Oh, shit.
What if she comes in, she comes in a bag over her head and her hands are tied up? He goes, you wanted her?
Yeah.
I got her.
He goes, don't go out in the hallway. Blood might start coming through the door. Lou? Black Lou, what did you do? He's like, I got the job done.
And they're just filming them, huh?
Yeah. I mean, by the way, are you talking about because Dr. Phil was on Nikki's show?
I forgot about that.
You know what? That doesn't bother me at all because he's a piece of shit.
No, I'm not. I'm just saying we don't have access to anybody.
I mean,
Dr. Phil was here in the morning, so no, I'm not even talking about that at all. I'm talking about when we see people who come in at this time, too. Like, why are we not fucking notified?
But did you not gauge that by the talent meeting that they were doing that because someone asked them to, that they don't give a shit?
I did get that vibe.
I got in that room and I was like, you guys are legitimately counting down until you could walk out of here and not do a goddamn thing.
What did the one guy do? Some guy in the meeting did something.
He did the wrap it up. He looked at another guy and he gave that.
This is plenty.
Yeah. We'll just have a good show and we'll book our own guests.
I want Paris Hilton right now. Did you watch your sex tape? Remember it?
Yeah. I watched it with the night
vision. How dicks are we if we just run that in the background on TV the entire time? Christine, please. Please. On the screen, the entire time she's in that room, please have her sex tape rolling.
Please.
Nothing else.
Oh, I mean,
she gives a real long jobber in that thing. Christine!
Dude.
Stop looking around. Direct order.
Let me tell you where Christine is. Christine's the person in the military that doesn't want to launch the missile.
Full screen.
Christine doesn't want to launch the missile. And Jay, you got your back to him?
In memory of 9/11 is how it starts.
I never forget.
I never realized that.
I mean, this is...
And this is my one night in Paris. Check it out.
Wonk, wonk.
She likes the cock.
I mean.
Oh, shit. Now I'm uncomfortable. Don't change it, Christine. We're impractical joking ourselves. Put it back on. Put it back on. Put it back on the screen, please.
I didn't get it.
Put it back on the screen, please. Put it back on the screen. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Put it back on the screen.
I got to move seats.
Oh, he's boofing her. She's getting boofed so hard. Fun.
I gotta move seats.
She's throwing job at it.
All right, get it off. I'm feeling bad now.
Yeah.
No, you don't. Why? Because your dick's not that big? Rick Solomon, he was bedding them all at that time.
Yeah, dude, he banged, like, bring up who Rick Solomon banged. It was a list. You should just put a picture of Rick Solomon's dick up on the see if she notices it.
Christine, just a giant picture of his dick.
Rick Solomon's dick.
Put it back. Put it back on the screen. Put it back on the screen for a second. Is this the pop? Christine, don't turn it off on the pop.
Oh, my God. I got to leave the board.
Lou.
Yeah, turn around, Lou.
Oh, she's taking it in the chops.
The fat Jewish is looking at me.
Is he?
No, bring up Rick Solomon's dick and then bring up, just find a picture of Rick Solomon's dick.
Just look up Rick Solomon dick. Add to that search. If you showed me your dick, I'd take a look.
Thanks, dude.
Thanks, dude. You're welcome.
I was like,
you know what it is? Maybe dick was wrong. Put cock. I feel like he is a dick, and that's going to bring up a lot of other things. I like your penis. There it is.
Oh, that's so funny. Dude, what is so funny if she's like mid-conversation and she just goes like this? She goes, anyways, from the next PV. Oh, my God.
That's not it. Go back to the other one.
Oh, my gosh.
The stretchy one. Yeah, there you go. But that's...
It's a good dick.
Yeah, the guy had a solid piece. I mean, you saw in that beach scene, he was rocking it. Christine's looking for better shots, I guess.
Well, she's the photographer. He married Pamela Anderson?
Oh, he had relationships. Did he marry her?
It says divorce papers.
Where is she at?
She's behind you. Back. Her back's to us.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, you know, if her face was to you, she'd be throwing neck at it.
Yeah.
Isn't the fat Jewish the guy that stole a bunch of comedy bits and made him popular?
Fat Jewish.
He stole a Michael Che joke, turned it into a meme.
And now he stole our guest, Paris Hilton.
That's like it. So his whole thing is just famous for
stealing jokes.
Copyright infringement?
Have we reached out to see if she can come on?
Lou's checking.
Okay.
Black Lou's bullying him.
Oh, Black Lou's out there. I mean, he's out there working.
No, he's better. He better pull the, why? Because I'm a black person on a show. She won't come in. He should definitely pull that card.
Yeah. He goes, you don't want to be on a black show? Walks in, it's just four white people.
That's the entire reason he's on the show. So we could do things like that. Oh, I get it. She doesn't want to be in the room with a black man. Well, all right, we'll go tell our fans.
Yeah, no, it's cool. You know what's weird? TMZ's
in
there.
I'll come in.
She's still so gorgeous.
I watched her get bounced out of line at a Delta fucking check-in at DIA.
Makes her not hot?
Just made my day. I'm watching her try to cut the entire line.
You think that makes her not hot, though?
Oh, no. She's hot.
I bet if she fucked you, you'd think her stories were great.
I go like this.
You know, man, she's actually lived a pretty like full life, and she's a lot of adventures.
Not if I just bang you, Jay. I have to have a crush on you.
Yeah, dude. She still looks...
She's like, perfect.
She's not perfect. I bet you could bang her, Lou. Why don't you start drinking that
she's
vodka?
So dumb, I could trick her.
Can we just, do we have a zoomed-in picture of like her tits out or something? Yeah. That we can just do that?
Did see if she recognizes
no.
Did you get her?
It's possible.
Is it? Possible.
I had to pull some strings. I had to lie.
What'd you say?
Did you have to fuck a fat chick who works here?
Coming out called Two Questions with a Guest We Couldn't Get. And if she could just come in real quick, we'll ask a couple questions.
What are the two questions? Where have you been?
We'll figure out what she can say.
Where have you been?
Can we ask two questions? Where have you been? Number one of them.
Yeah. And could you beat up Pamela Anderson in a fight? Because you guys both dated Rick Solomon.
Oh, I was going to say, I was going to have her rank us who she wants to fuck more. All of us.
Don't do that.
Everyone.
All in the room?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm going to say Christine wanted to know.
Yeah.
And Christine also included.
Yeah.
When she backs, backs against the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Gun to your head.
Night vision goggles on.
Night vision goggles on. That was, I hope somebody at home got how funny that was. Night vision on.
Night vision on.
It does. Most of that video is just like a fucking raccoon getting fucked.
Just looks like a
fucking raccoon footage.
It just looks like a raccoon go through a pail of trash.
Wait, what is it again? We have to ask her questions about...
No, I was talking to the people up front to see if that they would talk to her people to get her in.
Oh, right, she's right. Not coming on the show.
What? I didn't think she would.
Did
either.
You tell her it's Comedy Central Radio?
I did say that as well, yes.
Did you say Nikki Glaser's in here?
Yeah, tell her Nikki Glaser's here.
You go, bitch, do you want the freshest, dopest, most progressive show?
My first question to you, bitch, what's up?
My second question is...
Oh, Jesus, dude. You might have shit yourself a little bit.
I don't know.
That was one of those ones where you clenched your cheeks.
But that really
now you got to smell your microphone.
You really climbed up there to do that.
I was like, how hard to make Christine laugh? I don't think I've made Christine laugh harder than that.
I don't see why I deserve that.
What? You didn't? Oh, just to
no,
see
really,
do
Dan's got
to
eat it the
take
rest
it
of the
down
time.
Wind. Take it downwind.
You know, it's funny you say that, and I started chewing on it, and I was like, that wasn't a good idea.
Yeah.
Second question is the air thick in front of your face?
Can you ask her why she wears sunglasses inside?
Yeah.
My second question is, can you tell I'm a vegetarian?
Do you smell E. coli? Because I couldn't have lettuce today at Chipotle.
He goes, can you tell I've stopped drinking dairy?
Can you smell the cereal late at night? Are they giving you so you can't cut into their studio? You can, it's just immoral.
It is immoral.
I take your studio, I drink it up. No, I want to know what they're talking about.
I'm sneezing.
Dumb things.
You don't mean that.
You don't mean that at all, dude.
I mean it.
Tell them we're stealing the radio show.
Are they giving? Are they giving the fat Jewish a show?
I hope so.
No, I don't think. Well, I mean, we're just drawing that out of nothing.
Why is he in here? There's not
a guest.
There's not another host in there.
Yeah, it's like just the fat Jewish.
They're not giving Lenny Kravitz a show either. He was here today.
He was?
God, how did I miss that?
Ah, seriously, how did I miss that?
Lenny Kravitz?
Yeah.
I just saw his name on the board. How did you miss that? Because they don't send anybody down this hallway to our show. Wrap it up.
You know what I'm excited about is when Sirius, like the hires up, hear us tell them, like say on the air, like, oh, they don't give a shit about us. And then they do that insincere thing where they go, why do you think that?
You're like,
we had a whole meeting with the talent.
Oh, I feel like they go like, yeah, they get it.
You know what's really cool that happened that I was excited about, and this is something where I, you know,
shout out to Comedy Central though for always getting.
Obviously, love the show, yeah. But what's happening is that their guests were like, we've, you know, tried to reach out to people and it hasn't gone anywhere. But word of mouth, man, Bert Kreischer, you know, tells somebody that the Bonfire is great and go on it, and then I have their people reaching out to us. So
yeah.
Hopefully that word of mouth and the fact that people have a fun time on here, more people will start coming in.
And our microphones taste like fart.
The upstairs in the office, the mail is overflowing, so if that's any indication.
Ooh.
Christine, what are your two questions you would ask her? Have you ever seen Kim Kardashian unshaven?
Oh, yeah.
What was the shape of Kim Kardashian's original bush?
Oh, good call.
That's not what you would ask.
No, it's not what I would ask.
I would ask her if Kim Kardashian answers.
You love that world. What would you ask?
I would ask her if Kim Kardashian still takes her calls.
Ooh, that's not a bad one.
Harry.
You know what? Let's go around the room. Let's say if she does come in, let's go around the room and say that we were told by your people through the channels that everybody in the room can just only ask you two questions. So I just always ask two questions.
Hi, Dan Soder, MTV2's Guy Court. Number one question, where you been? Number two.
What did your poop look like?
Can you smell me? what are your two questions, Christine?
Mm-hmm. Where did you get your leather knuckle gloves from?
I thought that was going to be Jay's. Mm-hmm. I thought that was Jay's question.
Is she wearing them now?
Yep.
Sick.
You know what you should do is put your hands up to the window, bang them against, go like this. What's up? Go like this, Jay. Huh? Huh?
Twinsies.
And do you want new girlfriends?
Oh.
They're talking. She's talking to fat Jewish right now.
Do you want to be my friend?
Which means I have a shot.
Yeah, you do. Because I'll tell you this.
I'm also fat and Jewish.
No, you're big.
Well, I look cooler than fat Jew, I hope.
Yeah, you look cooler. What? What's wrong? Black Lou just had an epiphany. I watched him have an epiphany on his face.
Even if she says no, what if we put on one of her songs and open the door? This way, when she's walking by, she got to hear it.
Oh, my God.
She got to at least pay attention to it.
It was just a drunk text. Is that her that does that song?
What are their songs?
Oh, dude, drunk text.
Like, let's take a selfie.
Turn it up.
Dude, drunk text is the best one.
Well,
it's ridiculously shitty.
You're saying to give her a siren song. She comes in.
With my bitches.
Oh, God damn it.
It makes me pretty happy it only has 20,000 views.
That's this version.
It's like, I'm sorry for what I said last weekend. I told him I didn't mind, which was a lie.
What is this?
Nothing.
Sorry.
All
right. Is this her talking?
Come on, fat Jewish. What are you doing? The Seder in there? Let's go.
Dude, I would love to. Can we do a bonfire song with this beat where it's just us talking? Where I go, Vecchione asked if I was going to eat more cereal.
Yeah. My sugar goes, he's very judgmental of my carb intake.
I didn't save my last game of Madden. I didn't realize it until the next day.
He says I gave him soft kisses on his neck, but I don't remember.
Yeah, can you guys do that like now?
Later.
I'll try to find instrumental.
Yeah.
He hands me another shot of vodka.
I got really angry when Jay asked if Cisco's was good. Sure. I told him, the migas.
I just want everyone to enjoy themselves.
Ooh. When I get a text
I asked Lou.
The photo I took up a dancer's.
I said, "You're gonna get stewed today." You know what he said?
Not realizing he said, what I had just said.
Of course, bitch.
Sorry, I sent you all those pictures last night, Lou. I was just feeling horny.
Her phone, screaming at me, and I say,
"Just a silly drunk text."
It was just a drunk text. I should have known they knew each other.
Put this full screen, Christine. Let her know we're talking. She has her back to us the whole time, doesn't she? Is there a meme of Fat Jewish getting like a bunch of people coming on his face or something? Can we have that on the screen? Because he can see us. What if we fought him? Drunk Jewish?
Fight me.
You want to fight him together?
He's like a fucking millionaire. The dude just marketed himself, stole enough jokes till he's a millionaire.
Can we,
I mean, there's a special place in hell.
Black Lou, go back out there, and whatever happens when they walk out, let's come in and just say that Fat Jewish called you the N-word. Let's just run with that.
Let's do it. I'll tell you this. We'll get on TMZ and Page Six, and I'm going to go like this. Dan Soder, those are the Bonfire. Did Fat Jewish really say that to your producer? I go, I don't know what it was. He opened the door. He looked him right in the eyes.
Lou's never lied to me before. Look, did I hear it? No, but why would he make that up? We were all fans.
I loved his jokes.
We were really good.
He had a lot of parallel thoughts from some great comics.
Yeah, like the greats.
Now I'm going to write a book on it called Behind the Mic, My Time. We're all just trying to get book deals.
It was just a drunk text. Have this prepared to go when she walks out of that room. When are we finding out if she's coming in?
They're not going anywhere. They're doing a fucking unmasked.
Yeah, shit. They are digging deep.
They're doing a fat Jewish.
So that covers the Jewish part. Now, why do they call you fat?
What donuts do you like? You started eating when you were a baby. When did you know that you were eating too much?
What if she's a feeder? What if that's what she's into now? Where she just walks around in lingerie and just keeps stuffing food into his face?
Oh, dude, let's ask her if she's into that. Can that be one of the questions?
Really funny about this? There's an outside shot that this is all really fun that you're listening to this now on the Lost Tapes. If we possibly had her in the studio for a half hour yesterday for the live show.
Yeah.
Terminator timelines. Like, what are they talking about? They they had her in studio.
She was nice.
They were all lovely with her.
Yeah, I really like her.
Super smart. Way smarter than they thought she was going to be.
Ah, dude, I'll tell you this. I love the song Drunk Text.
He goes, listen, I mean, it's not the greatest lyrics, but I mean, like, it's a great song.
It's produced well. You know, Halsey. How do you say it?
Halsey.
Why do I keep fucking that up? Halsey.
Because you were trying to neg her so she likes you.
Yeah, but she's dang cheesy.
You're coming back with a... you're going to come... back after this weekend with slicked back hair.
Oh, yeah.
Tight leather jackets.
I come in with a fucking high neck coat.
What's Kim Kardashian's big famous one?
No, I think she only did
this. This is her song?
Mm-hmm.
No, she has more music than this. Absolutely.
No, I think she didn't because it's so bad. Like, they don't want to, like, ruin their shit by putting out terrible stuff.
I just like ripping it apart. And meanwhile, on the screen, it says all proceeds for this video go to St. Jude's Children's Hospital. Uh-huh.
Well, that's how she made it so people couldn't make fun of it.
That's how retards pay it forward.
Yeah. That's how they go, now take care of my other friends.
I somehow figured it out. They are not so lucky.
Yeah, that's how you hedge your bets, is you go like, oh, all the money's actually going to a good thing, so.
How do you hate it that much? Like, well, it's for a good cause. And she shows her tits and ass in the video a bunch.
It's crazy how much
she is beautiful. I mean, Paris Hilton's beautiful.
Yeah.
She's fucking, we're looking at her. She's fucking hot as shit.
Yeah. Even though she's wearing a sequined...
She's dressed like Rocky, too. She's dressed like Rocky after he got money.
That's so funny.
Leather knuckle gloves and a big flashy jacket.
Dude, that's so goddamn funny. I didn't even think of that. She really does dress exactly like Rocky. Rocky
if too. You want to smell manly, it's smell manly. Sorry. What are you, an idiot? No, I'm not an idiot. A little punchy maybe. My brain gets mixed up sometimes. I wanted to come in so bad.
What's up, Black Lou?
What's it going to take? Black Lou, why don't you press Tam the window?
I want to. Have you heard her song with Fat Joe and Jadakiss?
What?
I think that's one of her most popular. No, Paris Hilton is called Fighting Over Me.
Come on.
Fat Joe's on it?
And Jadakiss, yep.
She had to have done something to them.
I ain't punchy. I got what you call, like, I don't know.
Relaxed brains.
But I ain't punchy, you know. It's just the way I talk.
It's just the way I talk. It's just the way I talk. I got a relaxed brain. Jadakiss?
So sexy.
Locks. Dude, we're going to have a chance to... we have a chance to Halsey her when she comes in.
Yeah.
We can really do it. We're going to listen to her music and be like, "That's what I didn't." I was actually ready to laugh and clown on it, but it's actually pretty good.
I'm sorry. That's great.
If you'll have me, I'll murder Christine right here.
Yeah.
On air.
Do you want me to take out all four of these chumps real quick? Jackie Chan style?
Yeah, I'm very aware of my dumb girl brain, but dumb boy brain's pretty funny too.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty dumb.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure.
Dipshit? Did you call moi a dipshit?
Eddie Furlong, my hero.
Did you call moi? I love that. That's a good T2 reference.
And if you want to shine them on, it's hasta la vista, baby.
Hasta la vista, baby.
That's you teaching Murkface stuff?
Yeah, Luke, that's Lou's conversation with Murkface in the office. He goes, you can't just go around tweeting at people. Murkface goes, why?
Because you'll get fired.
Why?
Well, here's the good news.
I'm going to go get my coffee.
You're going to get your coffee. We're going to wrap this Lost Tapes up.
Sorry.
We did. Hey, for the record.
Sorry for edging you,
we
campers.
Hey, listen. Maybe it happened yesterday. We don't even know. All I will tell you.
Paris Hiltonopoulos came on the show.
Christine, one more time. One more time before I do it. I like this game. The Russian roulette. And make it some raunch, though. Make it some raunch. Lou, look at her right in the face.
Down.
Black Lou, look at her right in the face while we do it. Christine, do it for a second. Stop putting your jacket on, Dan. You can't run away from this. Are you doing it?
Yeah, it's not loading.
You think Sirius turned off our internet because they knew what was happening?
Dude, they cut us off, dude.
Is it loading? Wait, no. Something more. Oh, yeah. Oh, she's throwing her chops at it, Dan. Christine, put it back up for a second. Put it back up for a second. Oh, it's so uncomfortable. It's so uncomfortable. All right, turn it off. Everybody, we love you.
We will
catch you next time on The Lost Tapes. DanSoder.com, BigJComedy.com. We love you guys.
Bye.